Hello friends, welcome to the next session on AVL tree. Yesterday we spoke about general properties of AVL tree, operations which can be carried on AVL tree, and we know AVL tree is a binary search tree which is height balanced, right? Today we'll look at how to create an AVL tree from scratch, and we'll look at the two cases of deletion in AVL tree. So let us start with the algorithm for insertion, the steps required for insertion. So insert the node in AVL tree using the same insertion algorithm of binary search tree. We saw in binary search tree, whenever inserting, what you do, you take a node, compare it with the root. If it is smaller than the root, go to the left side. If it is greater than the root, go to the right side. Again, carry out the same process. So in same way, we are going to insert a node in the AVL tree. So once the node is added, the balance factor of each node is updated. Every time you carry out insertion in an AVL tree, you need to calculate balance factor of each and every node again, right? Now, if any node balance factor is invalid, then what you do, you carry out the rotations. We also saw yesterday the four types of rotations associated with AVL tree, fine? So let us learn this in detail by taking a simple example. We'll be creating an AVL tree from scratch. Okay, now suppose these are the keys using which we'll be creating an AVL tree. The very first key, what you read is 30. You create a node, and the first node, so it is a root node. Fine, this is the root node, and its balance factor is 0. Its balance factor is 0. Next, what you insert is 20. So compare 20 with 30. 20 is smaller than 30, so it will become the left child of 30. Right? So 20 is inserted as left child of 30. Now again, calculate the balance factor. Balance factor of 20 is 0 because no left child, no right child. And balance factor of 30 is 1 because it has one left child. So balance factor is 1. Still it is a valid balance factor because we know what are valid balance factor. 0, 1 and minus 1. Next what you insert is 25. So again compare it with 30. It is smaller than 30. So go to its left. Now it is greater than 25. So insert it as a right child of 20. Fine. So 25 is inserted as right child of 20. Now check the balance factor again. Start calculating the balance factor. That is 25. Balance factor is 0. 20 is minus 1 because it has right child. So minus 1. 30's balance factor is plus 2. Why? Because it has two nodes on the left side. Left subtree has the height of 2. So it is 2. So now root is the imbalanced node. Root is imbalanced node. To balance it now, what you need to do, you need to carry out the rotation. Now, as per the rotations, what we spoke in the previous lecture, it needs double rotation, right? So carrying out the rotation, 25 will be the new root, 20 will be the left child, and 30 will be the right child. So 25 is the new root, 20 is the left child, and 30 is the right child. Remember, even after carrying out the rotation, it should maintain the binary search tree property. Now, calculate the balance factor again. The balance factor of 20 and 30 is 0. They are leaf nodes. And balance factor of 25 is also 0. Why? This is plus 1. This is minus 1. So it equates to 0. Fine. Now next look at. So this is our tree. 25, 20, 30. Now what you insert is new key as 40. Compare it with 25. Greater than 25. So come to right side. Greater than 30. So insert it at the right child of 30. So 40 is inserted as right child of 30. Now calculate the balance factor again. So balance factor of 40 is 0. 30 is minus 1 because it's a right child. 25 is minus 1. Why? Because 1, 2, that is minus 2 plus 1. So root balance factor is minus 1. So tree is still balanced. There's no need to carry out any rotation. Tree is balanced. Next, what you insert is 32, right? So again, compare it with 25, it is greater than 25, come to right side, compare it with 30, it is greater than 30, so again come to its right side, compare it with 40, but it is smaller than 40, so it will be added as left child of 40, right? 32 will be added as left child of 40. So 32 is added as left child. Now again, calculate the balance factor. So balance factor of 32 is 0, 40 is plus 1, 30 is minus 2 because on the right side it has 1 and and even for 25, right, the height of right subtree is 1, 2, 3, that is minus 3, This is 1, so plus 1. So balance factor is minus 2. Now you have two nodes which are imbalanced. That is 30 is also imbalanced and 25 is also imbalanced. In this case, what you'll do, you'll consider the node which is nearer to the insertion. The imbalanced node which is nearer to the insertion. Now insertion is made of 32 and 30 is nearer to insertion, right? So you consider this and carry out the rotation, right? Now again, you'll have left to right to left rotation, right? So the new root will be now 32, left child will be 30 and right child will be 40. So now again, calculate the balance factor of each node. Now the tree is balanced. Now the tree is balanced, right? Now next, this is the next what you insert is 100. So again, compare it with 25. Greater than 25, greater than 32, greater than 40. So insert it as a right child of 40. 100 is inserted as right child of 40. Now again, calculate the balance factor. Balance factor of 100 is 0, 40 is minus 1 because of the right child. 32 is minus 1 because it has two nodes on the right subtree and one on the left subtree. So it is minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1. Now, the balance factor of the root node is minus 2, that is check the height of the right subtree is 1, 2, 3, that is minus 3, and left side is 1, that is minus 1. So the root's balance factor is minus 2. So this is the node which is imbalanced. Now when this node is imbalanced, you need to select the three nodes which are on the path of insertion from the root node, right? So if you see from the root node, which are the nodes on the path of insertion, 100 is added on this path. So select these three nodes, fine, to carry out the rotation. We are not selecting these three. We are selecting these three because this is on the path where the insertion is made. Now, this is again left to left rotation. 32 will be the new root, 25 will be the left child, 40 will be the right child, and 30 will be right child of 25. So 32 is the new root, 25 is the left child, 40 is the right child, 100 remains at its position, and 30 is added as right child of 25. Fine. 20 remains as it is as left child of 25. Fine. Now check the balance factor again. So now the tree is balanced because 32 also has the balance factor 0. How come? 1, 2 plus 2, 1, 2 minus 2. So the balance factor of root is 0. Here it is minus 1. 25 is 0. 100 is also 0. Fine. Okay. Next, now what we insert is 200. So compare it with 32, greater than 32, greater than 40, greater than 100. So 200 will be inserted as right child of 100. Fine. Calculate the balance factor again. So now if you calculate the balance factor, 40 is imbalanced. Why? It does not have any right sub, left subtree, but on right subtree it has 1 and 2. The height of right subtree is 2. So the balance factor of 40 is minus 2. That means this node is imbalanced. Now, again, what will carry out? You will carry out left to left rotation. So once you carry out the rotation, 100 will be the new root, 40 the left child, and 200 will be the right child. Right? So 100 is the root, 40 left child, and 200 as the right child. Now, this is by mistake, it is 0. In fact, it is not minus 1, it is 0. Right? Now, calculate the balance factor again. When you calculate the tree is balanced, all the nodes have 0 as balance factor. Look at this. Please ignore this. This is by mistake. This is 0 in fact. Okay, next now what you insert is 50. Now the tree is balanced, right? Now when you insert 50, compare it with 32, greater than 32 but smaller than 40. So come the 100, so come on the left side, but it is greater than 40, so it becomes right child of 40. So 50 is inserted as right child of 40. Now calculate the balance factor again. Tree is balanced, right? The tree is balanced. Now next what you insert is 75, right? So where 75 will be inserted, greater than 32, smaller than 100, so go to left side, greater than 40, so come to right side, greater than 50, so go insert it as a right child of 50. So 75 is inserted as right child of 50. Now calculate the balance factor again. Now you check the balance factor of 40 is minus 2, right? 100 is also 2, that is plus 2, and the root node is also balanced, that is minus 2. So these are three nodes which are imbalanced. Now what you do, you need to carry out the rotation. Now whenever you want to carry out the rotation, you check the node which is nearest to the insertion, the node with the imbalance which is nearer to the insertion. So you'll select these three and carry out the rotation. Right, so we select this, the nearest one, though this is imbalanced, we select the node which is nearer to the insertion and carry out the rotation. So 50 will be the new root, 40 the left child, and 75 will be the right child. Fine. So 50 is the new root, 40 left child, and 75 is the right child. Now calculate the balance factor again. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, root balance factor is minus 1. 100 balance factor is plus 1 because on the left subtree, the height is 1, 2, right subtree height is 1, so it is plus 1. So tree is balanced now because all nodes have the balance factor between minus 1, 0, and plus 1. Now the last node what we'll be adding to our AVL tree is 10. Now, so how 10 will be inserted? Compare it with 32, it is less than 32, go to the left side, compare it with 25, less than 25, so again go to the left side, compare it with 20, less than 20, so it will be the left child of 20, right? It will be left child of 20. Now calculate the balance factor again of the tree. The tree is still balanced, right? The root node has 0. Why? The left subtree height is 1, 2, 3, right? Plus 3. Right subtree height is again 1, 2, 3, that is minus 3. So plus 3, minus 3, the balance factor of root is 0. Balance factor of 100 is 1, 25 is also 1. That means even after insertion of 10, the tree is balanced. So this is a final AVL tree which is created using these keys. I hope the concept is clear. Okay. Now along with the insertion, we'll also have to look at deletion. In case of deletion, again, the concept is same like what we had in case of binary search tree. So what you do first, find the element in the tree which you want to delete. Now delete the node as per the binary search tree deletion. What we had three cases in case of binary search tree, you're deleting a leaf node, you're deleting a node with one child, you're deleting a node with two children. So carry out that deletion as per the binary search tree. And after deletion, you need to check the balance factor of each and every node, and if required, you need to restructure the tree. So there are two possible cases when you're doing restructure after deletion. One is deleting from the right subtree, and if the deletion is from the left subtree. So we'll look at these two cases. Now, the case one is deleting from the right subtree. So it has three subcases here, right? So here, if the node, the balance factor of node is plus 2 and balance factor of nodes left child is plus 1, you need to perform left to left rotation. Similarly, if the balance factor of the node is plus 2 and the balance factor of nodes left child is minus 1, then you perform left to right rotation. And if it is balance factor is plus 2 and nodes left child's balance factor is 0, then you perform left to left rotation. Now this is if you are deleting from the right subtree. Now BF is nothing but balance factor. Now let us look at one by one the cases. Case one, now here, this is the tree, right? The node what you're going to delete is 70. The node in the green color is 70. Now once this node is deleted, this is what remains, right? Now the balance factor of 50 is plus 2. So it needs to be restructured so the balance factor is correct, fine? Now the deletion is from right subtree. Remember, this is the right child of this node. So deletion is from right subtree, fine? And what you get is now the imbalanced tree structure after deletion. Balance factor of 50 is plus 2, balance factor of 35 is 1, and balance factor of 20 is 0. In this case, now how do you check it again? Now the balance factor of node, that is 50, is plus 2, right? Now the balance factor of node's left child, now this is the node, its left child is 35 and its balance factor is plus 1, right? Then what you carry out? You carry out the rotation. So now 35 is a new child, 20 is the left new root, 20 is the left child, and 50 is the right child, fine? After carrying out the rotation, 35 is the new root, 20 the left child, and 50 is the right child, fine? Next. Here, now again, you are deleting a node from the right subtree, that is 70 you need to delete, and this is the left subtree. Fine. Now, after deleting 70, this is what remains, and the balance factor of 50 is plus 2, right? The balance factor of the node, that is 50, is plus 2, and balance factor of node's left child, that is 35, is minus 1. It is minus 1 because 40 is right child of 35, right? So 35's balance factor is minus 1. So what you perform left to right rotation. So 40 is the new root, 35 becomes the left child, and 50 becomes the right child. Is it fine? Now, the last case, when you're deleting a node from the subtree, again, this is the subtree, and we are deleting 70 from the right subtree. Now, after deletion of 70, this is the structure what remains. So the balance factor of the node is plus 2, because that is balance factor 50 is plus 2, 1 and 2, right? And balance factor of the node's left child, that is 35, is 0, right? Balance factor of 35 is 0, because plus 1, minus 1. So the balance factor of 35 is 0. So now you carry out left to left rotation. So these are the nodes which are considered for left to left rotation. So now 35 becomes the new root, 50 the left right child, and 20 the left child, right? And 35's right child will become 50's left child. Fine. 35's right child will become 50's left child. Fine. Okay. Now let us look at the second case, in case of deletion. Now when you're deleting it from the left subtree, case 1, we dealt with deletion from the right subtree. Case 2 is dealing with deletion from the left subtree. Again, similarly, we have three cases. We'll look at them one by one. Now here, 35 needs to be deleted, which is on the left subtree of the node. Fine. After you delete 35, this is what remains. And your 50 is imbalanced by the balance factor of 50 is minus 2, right? The balance factor of node 50 is minus 2. Balance factor of node's right child is also minus 1, right? So what you do, you carry out right to right rotation. So 70 is the new root, 50 is the left child, and 90 is the right child. Fine. You carry out the rotation. 70 is the new root, 50 is the left child, and 90 is the right child. In fact, it is left to left rotation. Fine. Okay. Next, now case 2. Again, you are deleting a node from the left subtree. You need to delete 35. After deleting 35, this is the structure what you get. So again, check the balance factor of node 50, that is minus 2. Balance factor of node's right child, that is plus 1, because 60 is left child of 70, so the balance factor of 70 is plus 1. So again, you carry out the rotation, and the new root is 60. 50 is the left child, and 70 is the right child. Fine. Next, the third case, in case 2. So again, deleting 35 from the left subtree, right? This is what remains after deletion. So again, check the balance factor of the node, that is minus 2 of 50, right? And balance factor of node's right child, that is 70 is 0. Of course, the balance factor of 70 is 0 because 60, that is plus 1, 90, that is minus 1. The balance factor of 70 is 0. Then you carry out the rotation. And now, the new root is, because this whole thing is rotated. Fine. So the new root is 70, 50 is the left child, and 90 is the right child. Fine. And the right left child of 70 becomes right child of 50. Left child of 70, that is 60, becomes right child of 50. Now the tree is balanced. Fine. I hope both the two cases, that is deleting from the right subtree and deletion from the left subtree, is clear. Now I want you all to try these examples. Try to create an AVL tree and randomly try to delete any key from it. Now when you're working with this textual data, take the lexicographic order of this, right? What does that mean? F is smaller than G, right? A is smallest. So keep this in your mind when you're working on it. Okay? So I expect you all to create 3 AVL trees. Thank you. I hope the concept is clear. It is very interesting because of the advantages AVL tree has. Only the problem comes when you're carrying out the insertion and deletion, because it has an extra overhead of rotations. Otherwise, searching is very fast because the height is maintained as log n. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.